Fine. Our last three examples are going to be looking at some word problems. In other words, why might we want to look for where something is increasing or decreasing, and why might we care about relative max and relative min? So in example 7 here, we have the Mexican subsidiary of a thermometer. So they are manufacturing a thermometer, and it says that management estimates that the profit in dollars realized by the company for the manufacture and sell of X units is given by the function below. So we have the profit given as a function of selling X units each week. So this is the weekly profit. Find the interval where the profit is increasing and where the profit is decreasing. So this would be something that you might be concerned about. When is our profit increasing? When we sell how many units? When we make, of course, we have to make them, which includes a cost, and then we have to sell them. We want to know where the profit is increasing and decreasing. And it looks like we also might want to know what relative max or relative min may be for my profit. So we're giving our answers once again using interval notation. So in order to find out where the profit is increasing or decreasing, remember that we have to find the first derivative. And this is a pretty nice first derivative. We're just going to use the power rule. So we're going to multiply 2 times negative 0.002, which gives us negative 0.004. Reduce our power by 1, so we get x plus 4. So really nice, easy derivative there, considering all the ones we've done so far. So once we find the first derivative, we're looking for two things. We're looking for where the first derivative is 0, or where the first derivative might come back undefined. Now, where the first derivative is 0 is actually turns out to be a pretty easy equation to solve, considering all the ones we've solved so far. We're going to take this equation, set it equal to 0. We'll subtract our 4 to the other side, divide both sides by negative 0.004, and then I get x equals, I'll just throw that in my calculator, I get x equals 1000. All right. Now, where does my first derivative equal something undefined? Well, notice something here. Notice that I do not have a variable in a denominator, so there's no way that I can test out and say, okay, set the denominator equal to 0 because there is no denominator here. And also, there are no negative exponents to put in the denominator. So at this point, it is not possible to have an undefined result because there's no denominator. And remember that we can only have something that is undefined if we set our denominator equal to 0. And if we don't have a denominator to set equal to 0, then it's not possible. So this one turns out to be pretty straightforward. Our number line, we're going to put 1,000 on there. We're going to put that in the box. Another piece of information that I want to bring to your attention here is that it gives us a restriction. We can't sell a negative number of units. So our number line actually will also include 0 as kind of a stopping point. We're not considering an x value that is negative because we can't manufacture negative units. So we're only starting at 0 and going to 1,000. And we could go past that if we want to, but can't go below that. So we can go larger than 1,000, but we can't go large smaller than 0. So we're going to pick some test values here. Remember, we're not considering anything less than 0, but we can pick a test value in between 0 and 1,000. Pick anything you want. I'm going to pick 1. That'll work. Pick anything I want to the right. Pick anything you want. I'm going to go with 2,000. Okay, it doesn't matter what you pick, you can pick 1,001, anything to the right. That will be fine. All right. So I'm going to put these, remember, we want to test them in the first derivative. So I'm going to put 1 into the first derivative and we'll see what we get. Okay, and it should be pretty clear here that we're going to get something that is definitely positive, right? Because negative 0.004 times 1 is negative 0.004 plus 4, a really small negative number plus a positive 4, that's going to give us something positive. So this would tell me that we're increasing to the left of 1,000. So between 0 and 1,000, definitely increasing. We get a positive slope. What about 2,000? So we'll put in 2,000 here. Oops, one more 0. And let's see what we get when we plug in 2,000 multiply it by negative 0.004, and then add 4 to it. Looks like when I put that in my calculator, I get a negative 4. Okay, so test it out and see what you get. The fact that it's negative, the fact that I get a negative slope here, tells me that we are decreasing from 1,000 and onward. So decreasing. So we're asked to find intervals of increasing and decreasing. So I'm going to go ahead and just label these as increasing, decreasing. Looks like we're increasing from 0 to 1,000. And notice that we're still using parentheses here because we're talking about those open intervals still. And we're decreasing from 1,000 to positive infinity. So as many as we would like to manufacture and sell, the higher we go, looks like our profit is going down. Now this could be a cost issue. Maybe the cost is too great for how many that we end up actually selling. There's a price and demand function going on around in there as well. So a lot of things could contribute to this idea that the profit would go down after 1,000 units. Well, what about a relative max here? Let's say that we asked for a relative max. We would definitely have a relative maximum because we're increasing, so we're going up, 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 and then we kind of level off and then we start coming back down. So it looks like at 1,000, we would call that our relative maximum. So at 1,000 units, that would be kind of your ideal number of units to make and sell. Looks like at 1,000, you have a relative maximum for your profit there. So that's what I would go with. All right, example 8, we have another word problem here. It says, following the lead of the National Wildlife Federation, the Department of the Interior of a South American country began to record an index of environmental quality that measured progress and decline in the environmental quality of its forest. The index for the years 2004 to 2014 is approximated by the following function. T equals 0, so we have some limitations here on our T values, what can go in. We're only looking from 0 to 10. We're not looking anything less or larger than that. It looks like T equals 0 corresponds to the year 2004. We're asked to find where the intervals are increasing and where they are decreasing. So of course, anytime we're asked for increasing and decreasing intervals, we want to find the derivative of the function. Here, once again, what's really nice here, we're just using the power rule. So 3 times 1/3 will give us 1. And then we'll have t, and we'll reduce our power by 1, so we get t squared. 2 times 3 over 2 will give us negative 3, and then t, and then reduce our power by 1. And this is just a constant, which is really nice. So we end up with actually something, let's just write it a little simpler, we end up with t squared minus 3t. Really nice and easy derivative there. And remember, we're looking for two things, and we're looking for increasing intervals. We're looking for where the function is 0, where that derivative would give a result of 0, and where it might come back undefined. And we can tell here that it's not going to come back undefined because we don't have a denominator or any negative exponents that would put a variable in the denominator. So we won't worry about that one. So we're just going to figure out what t value would cause our derivative to equal 0. In order to solve this equation, we're going to set our derivative equal to 0, and we're going to factor out a t. So I'm going to factor out a t, and we end up with t times t minus 3 equals 0. Set each one of those factors equal to 0, and end up with t equals 0, and t equals positive 3. So we're going to set up our number line again. Remember that 0 is as small as we can go, and we have a 3 in our little box there, and the highest that we can go is 10, and I'm not going to put that into a box or anything, but we do know that the intervals only go from 0 to 10. We don't go anything, we don't test anything less than 0, anything greater than 0, because the function is only good from 0 to 10. So nothing larger than 10 is going to be considered for t, and nothing smaller than 0 will be considered for t. So we're just basically looking between 0 and 3 and 3 and 10, seeing where we're increasing and decreasing. All right, so let's choose some test values. I am going to go ahead and put this in a box because that's the largest that t can be. So I'm just going to go ahead and put that in a box because we'll use that for our intervals. Let's pick some test values now. So we're going to test some values to find out what are the slope of the tangent line will come back, positive or negative. I'm going to choose 1 and I'm going to choose 4. And you can choose any values that you want. And remember that we're plugging them into the first derivative. So we're plugging them into the first derivative. Remember, this is our slope formula, and we're testing to see whether or not the slope is positive or negative. So I get 1 squared minus 3 times 1. That's 1 minus 3. That gives me negative 2. Care about the fact that it's negative tells me that my tangent lines are going downhill from left to right, so therefore the function is decreasing from 0 to 3. All right, let's do the same thing for our test value that we chose of 4. 4 squared minus 3 times 4. I get 16 minus 12, which gives me a positive 4. Positive slope tells me that we're increasing as we move from left to right. So we are decreasing from 0 to 3. We are increasing from 3 to 10. Corresponds, let's just write this down here, that corresponds to the year 2004 to 2007. And then looks like the environmental quality index here starts to go up from the years 2007, so in between 2007 and 2014. All right, so and we are able to figure out where we're increasing and decreasing. Remember that we're using the open intervals, we're using the open parentheses on our solutions there. All right, in our last example here, we're looking at a mid-sized sedan, and we're looking at the average cost, which includes car payments, gas, insurance, upkeep, and depreciation in cents per mile. So we're given here cents per mile, the average cost to drive this mid-sized sedan. It says here that X is given in thousands of miles that the car is driven. So it looks like we're talking about this function applying to 5,000 miles to 20,000 miles. And what we want to show here is that the cost, the average cost, is decreasing as the car is driven from 5,000 to 20,000 miles. So the average cost to own this car and drive it is going down for 5,000 to 20,000 miles. One thing you want to notice about this particular function is that their variable is in the denominator. So before we find a derivative, notice that I'm not writing a little the little tick mark there. Before we actually find the derivative, we're going to rewrite the original function so that the variable is in the numerator. Okay, and that becomes a negative 1.72. So it's $1,910.5, and then we have x to the negative 1.72 power, and then we have the plus 42.9. All right, and I said dollars, not necessarily dollars, but 1910.5, we'll just leave it at that, and then times x to the negative 1.72 power plus 42.9. So now we can find the derivative, and notice this time I'm writing the little prime symbol. So it's c prime of x is equal to, we're going to do the power rule, so negative 1.72 times the 1910.5. Put that in our calculator, and I got a negative 3,286.06. All right. We're going to reduce the power by 1, so we're going to subtract 1 from the power. That gives me negative 2.72. And what's nice here is that this is a constant term, and so the derivative of that is 0, so we don't have to write it. Now, before we actually conclude our derivative situation, I am going to go ahead and bring the negative exponent back down. I'm going to make it positive. I'm going to bring it back down to the denominator so we can actually use it. So I'm going to write it with positive exponents before I go and use it. All right. So we're looking for a couple of things. We're looking for where either the first derivative is 0 or where the first derivative is undefined. Okay, so if we take our first derivative written in that form in the box there, set it equal to 0, we'll put the 0 over 1, we'll cross multiply, I get 0, remember anything times 0 is 0, keep that simple, and then I get equals negative 3,286.06. Okay, well, first of all, our variable's gone. We have a false statement, and we said in the case where you have the variable disappearing and you have a false statement, then there's going to be no solution for this. So there's no solution for where the variable or where the first derivative would equal zero. What about where the first derivative would come back undefined? Now this time we notice that we have a variable in the denominator. So where, how, what x value would cause our denominator to equal zero? Well, we have x to some power, that's all we have. What's the only way that I can take x, raise it to some power, and get zero? And the only way that that can happen is if x itself is zero. Okay, so the only value that we have to separate our number line is x equals zero. So we'll put zero in our box there. All right. Now, you notice that the function that we're given is only good from 5, x equals 5, to x equals 20. So I'm going to put these values in boxes, because this is really where the function starts and ends. Actually, this function really doesn't even work for anything less than 5 or anything greater than 20. Now, this is kind of tricky in a way. Really, the only value that I got from my number line is 0. Okay, now these come from the function. So I can pick anything to the right of 0 and anything to the left of 0. Now remember, I'm not using any negative. We can't drive the car negative number of miles, so I'm not using anything negative. And in fact, the function says we're only interested in things, what's happening between 5 and 20. So I can pick any test value that I want to the right of 0. So I can pick 1, I can pick 2, I can pick anything to the right of 0. If it helps, you can pick something like 6, because 6 is in between 5 and 20, and that kind of makes sense there to choose that. Or you could choose 1. Really, you could choose anything to the right of 0. These are also probably test values that you could use as well. But let's just choose 6, okay? Because we're interested in what's happening between 5 and 20, let's choose 6. And remember, where we're plugging this in, we're plugging it into our first derivative. And I'm going to plug it into the one that has that positive exponent. Right, I'm going to throw that into my calculator, see what I get there. I really don't even need to do that. You could do that if you want to. What do I care about here? I care about if the answer is going to come back positive or negative. Obviously, the denominator is going to be positive because I have a positive power and I have a positive base. So 6 raised to the 2.72 power is definitely going to come back positive. The numerator is negative, so it's definitely negative. So what do I get? I get something negative. So we are decreasing from 5 to 6. So this proves what we were asked to show, that between the numbers 5 and 20, that the function was definitely decreasing. So the average cost is going down between 5,000 and 20,000 miles.